Good morning, students. I welcome you all to English Reader session. Today we will be discussing chapter number 4, A Teacher for All Seasons, written by Joanna Fuchs. Beta, this is a beautiful poem. Before starting this poem, we have already covered chapter 1 to 3 of Reader, and before starting this poem, I want all of you to pay attention to your class test, which we have started scheduling for your revision. These tests will be helpful for you to prepare for the unit test paper, and it will boost up your confidence. So focus on your class test and focus during the revision classes. Okay, and pay attention. All the best for your class test as well as for the unit test. Beta, who is Joanna Fuchs? Before that, I'll tell you about the poem. We will recite the poem together. See, in this poem, Beta, the poet expresses the gratitude, thankfulness to a teacher for being a truly perfect person who is suitable for all seasons. Here the poet compared teacher with all the seasons. And as a teacher who is a pleasant, encouraging attitude that wins heart wherever he or she goes. This poem plays a tribute to a teacher who plays various roles. He plays a role of a friend. He plays a role of a guide. And here the poet compares various roles of a teacher to the various four seasons. Okay, so let's recite the poem, Beta. And firstly, I'll tell you about the poet. Who is Joanna Fuchs? Beta, Joanna Fuchs, she is a professional writer and has written over 400 poems. And awards-winning stories for children. She used to write the poem for the children. And A Teacher for All Seasons is one of her famous poems. So let's recite the poem. In this poem, see, Beta, A Teacher for All Seasons. Here the teacher is compared with all the seasons. Yes? A teacher is like spring, who nurtures new green sprouts, encourages and leads them whenever they have doubts. So a teacher is like a spring season. In spring season, as the green sprouts that nurtures, so as with the teacher, it encourages their children to grow, and all their doubts are cleared by the teacher. Nurture means to care for. Here the teacher cares for their children, na? As in the spring season, green sprouts, when we take care of green sprouts, it gets nurtured. Okay, it's grown up. Yes, next is, and on the next line on the screen is, a teacher is like summer, whose sunny temperament makes studying a pleasure, preventing discontent. Here the teacher is comparing with the summer season, whose sunny temperament. As you know, the temperament is a different kind of nature. Sometimes a teacher behaves like a friend. Sometimes he behaves in a very rude way, in a very different way, in an aggressive manner also, only just for your good sake. So it, her or his temperament gets changed according to the as per the class students. Okay, so temperament, Beta, it's a person's nature as seen in any situation. According to situation, person's nature gets changed. As with the teacher's nature gets changed according to the situation. Okay, Beta, sometimes a teacher used to play with you. Sometimes he is very harsh, he is very aggressive with you, okay? So here we are comparing a teacher with the summer season. And teacher prevents us from discontent from unhappiness. Yes. Next is, a teacher is like fall. Which method is crisp and clear? Lesson of bright colors and a happy atmosphere. See, a teacher is like a fall. Here we are comparing a teacher with the methods here. His or her methods are very crispy. Crisp means it's very pleasant. It's very clear. Clear and cut. And lessons of bright color and a happy atmosphere. She provides us a happy atmosphere around us. So with the bright colors, she used to teach us. She spreads all the colors around us. And the next is, see on the screen, yes? See, a teacher is like winter. While it's snowing hard outside, you are a teacher for all season and you have my gratitude. So here, we are comparing teacher to all seasons. You do all these things. Here the poet is expresses his feeling that a teacher does each and every thing for our children with a pleasant attitude and with a happy attitude, with a happy nature. So you are a teacher for all seasons and you have my gratitude. Gratitude, it's my thankfulness. So here the poet is expressing his thankfulness. Clear? Next is, bitter gratitude when we want to express our thankfulness to someone. Clear, bitter? So this is all about the poem. Now I am going to conclude the poem. In this poem, a teacher is a person who has a great responsibility towards the students and the society as well. The poem is addressed to the teacher who serves as a friend, as a philosopher and guide for their students. The poet has compared a teacher to the different seasons here. He says that a teacher showers his or her love, affection, concern towards his children by rendering his or her unconditional love. A teacher's love is unconditional, like a mother's love, and support to his or her student. It's a beautiful poem, a teacher for all seasons. Beta, read this poem once again and I'll send you the question answer of this poem. Write it down in your fair notebook and learn it also. Learn word meaning also. And all the best for your unit test and for your class test. Thank you so much. Have a nice day. All the best. God bless you all. Thank you.